إن الحمد لله إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا إنه من يهده الله فهو المهتدي ومن يضلل فلن ينتج له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله شهادة تنجينا من عذاب النار ويدخلنا الجنة من غير سابقة عذاب ولا عقاب وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه أشهد أنه قد بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة ومحى الغمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين فصلاة وسلاما على عبدك ونبيك محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: لقد جاءكم رسول من أنفسكم عزيز عليه ما عنتم حريص عليكم بالمؤمنين رؤوف رحيم. أما بعد, all praise to Allah, all praise to Allah, the one, the only, the one who should be worshipped. I bear witness that he is the creator of this universe and he is the one who should be worshipped. I bear witness that Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam is his messenger. True mercy sent to us. If we follow his path, inshallah, we'll be in Jannah. Amma ba'd. Today, as we can follow the news, imagine that I have now an imaginary story that someone went to a cave for thousands of years. He doesn't know anything about anything. And he waked up today to follow what's happening around us. And someone's telling him, oh, there is a man who died from 1400 years. There are people insulting him. Oh, really? Oh, this is the bad man, definitely. What did he do? There are two billion people are following him. Okay, that's good. Okay, that's good. What's the bad part? I need to see. Why you're insulting him? Oh, because he was trustworthy. I'm telling you why you are saying what you're saying. Why you are doing? It's freedom of speech. And I ask a question. What? What's the freedom of speech? Everything, I like a definition. Put a definition and I'll follow. What's your definition of freedom of speech? He said, everyone has the right to say whatever he wants and anytime he wants. Great. You agree with that? Do you agree with this definition? He said, yes. Okay, if I go to a one who died now in your church and I start insulting the deceased, would you like that? It's freedom of speech. I can do it, right? With your definition. No. This is different. Why it's different? Because it's freedom of speech. You cannot, it's ideology. Oh, really, ideology? Okay, now you're talking about ideology. No problem. Then you're not after the person, you're after his ideology. Okay, fair enough. Then if I say that women are bad, you will not tell me about anything. Oh, no, this is sexism. You cannot say that. Women, you cannot talk about women. Come on. You cannot say that. So why? Because this is based on gender. You cannot do that. He said, okay, then what should I do? He said, okay, how about if I say you are black or white? No, this is racism. Okay. How about I insult a group? No, you cannot do that. It's bullying. He said, what? You cannot do that. It's bullying. You shouldn't do that. Okay. How about if I say about religion? Part of anti-Semitism immediately. Thrown in you. Any anti, anything. Okay, what's freedom of speech then? What are you talking about? Oh, you meant you're free to insult me, but not free to respond. Oh, you can respond to insult our prophet. Who's your prophet? Jesus. I cannot insult Jesus. He's my prophet too. How can I insult my prophet? Jesus is one of my prophets. If I insult him, I'm out of Islam. I cannot do that. Then really the freedom of speech is just insulting someone who didn't do anything. It reminds me of Qawm Lut. Qawm Lut, subhanAllah, they asked Sayyidina Lut to leave the town. أَخْرِجُوا آلَ لُوتٍ مِّن قَرِيَةٍ. Kick the people of Lut outside the place. Why? What did he do? Are they bad? Doing something bad? No. إِنَّهُمْ أُنَاسٌ يَتَطَهَّرُونَ. They are so clean, so modest. What? This is the definition of freedom of speech. This is the freedom of speech. Let's talk about the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. The Prophet gave the freedom of speech to everyone, but on basis without insult. Yes, you can tell me what you want, whatever you want, but don't insult me. Why are you insulting me? If you're insulting me, you're insulting me. Define the ideology you're talking about. The Prophet والسلام, is a mercy. 2 billion people are following him. Even if they are following literally or following a little bit, still they are following it. They're really him. Then really, I ask you, why are you doing that? Under the freedom of speech? No. This is very bad. The Prophet والسلام, his acts, his goodness, is defined by people and by the most powerful Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah said about him, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. Subhanallah. This is a witness from Allah himself. His friends, he is the most trusted, the most worthy person in the world. Okay, maybe they are your friends. How about his enemies? How about his enemies? Maybe someone will say, his enemies will say bad things about him. Abu Sufyan, after Ghazwat al-Sulh Hudaybiyah, he went and Hiraql. Sayyidina Rasulullah sent messages to everyone. And one of the messages was for Hiraql. Who is Hiraql? Caesar, the head of Rome. He was in Syria at that time, because the kingdom was there. And he said, okay, bring someone who knows Muhammad والسلام, bring him in. Let me talk to him. And who was there at that time? Abu Sufyan. At that time, he was his main enemy. And what when he was asked, come, what do you know about the Muhammad? Was he trustworthy? And Abu Sufyan, his enemy. And his enemy even couldn't lie. He said, yes, he is trustworthy. He is trustworthy. He was known by that for 40 years. He didn't lie a single lie. And Hiraql told him, if someone is not lying for people, he will definitely not lie for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A man, alayhi salatu wasalam, was followed to the letter. Tell me one human, male or female, was known by every act he does in his life. When he goes inside his house, when he leaves the house, when he talks to his wife, when he even sleeps with his wife, when he goes to the washroom, when he leaves the washroom, when he talks, when he walks, even his wudu, what they do with it. Tell me someone was followed to the point that everyone is following him. And not only following him, but even writing that to us. He's writing even his smiles, his talk, his walk, and how he was trying to send his message to all of us. Tell me, who in the world does that? Tell me a man or a woman have written in this world all this information about him. And come someone under the liberty of act, and he's starting insulting him. If you insult the son, do you think this will affect the son? No. Then really, tell me, what is the benefit of all of that? The benefit, alayhi salatu wasalam, to know him. I'll talk about one before the khutbah, the second part of the khutbah. The first one, get some knowledge. Really, it's pushing all of us Muslims, 2 billion, to know him better. We need to know our Prophet better. We need to understand him better. We need him to love him more. To know him more. To see his acts more. To see his mercy more. And to understand that he's there for us. Like I narrated in the ayah, لَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ Allah sent you. لَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ مِّنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ A messenger from you. Azizun alayhi ma'arif. He doesn't want anyone to go astray. Harisun alaykum. He is so trying his best to make every one of you go to Jannah. Even his enemies. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfiru alaykum fastaghfiru ya fawza al-mustaghfir. Inna alhamdulillah nahmadu wa nasta'inu wa nastaghfiru wa nastahdi wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina wa sayyiati a'malina. Amma ba'd. Really? Really, I was trying to get the hikmah of why sometimes these things happen. I know it's not written anywhere, but really, when you think about it, why someone insults someone, died from 40, do you imagine that I talk to you and I tell you, you know your fifth grandfather is very bad and start inserting the fifth grandfather of yours. You don't know him. I don't know him. It doesn't make any sense. What are you doing? What are you doing? Really, what are you doing? I don't know him. Subhanallah. But I believe the hikmah from this. Sometimes Allah, I think, Allah wants us to be looking, who is the Prophet? One of the hikmah, I think, knowledge. We want to get some more knowledge. Allah is telling all of us, get some more knowledge about the Prophet, know him more. Because really, we are having a lack of information about the Prophet. Two, he wants us to raise our voices with the salah alayhi salatu wasalam. To raise our voices with saying as-salatu wasalamu alayka ya Habib Allah. Three, subhanAllah, these things happen in his birth or death days. Because 12 was yesterday, subhanAllah, right? 12 yesterday? Yeah, 12 was yesterday. And this is a day that most of the ulama are saying he may be born on that day. Even though I don't see it that day. I know he's dead that day, Monday, 12th of Rabi' al-Awwal. But anyway, with that being said, I think that one of the hikmah of why this is happening for us to raise our voices to know him more and to say his name more and to talk about him more and understand him more. I'll add one more thing, which is really every catastrophe happened around us. I like to reflect. Look at the people who revert. I don't like the word convert because convert, I believe, is going out. Reverse coming back. The people who joined Islam, because imagine someone tells you, this man is bad. Okay, someone doesn't know anything about anything. He said, okay, who is that man? Let me read about him. And subhanAllah, in France, people are joining Islam because of that. The fools, if they stop talking about him, people may forget about him. But subhanAllah, because they talk a lot, people hear him. Why they're insulted? Why they don't insult Hitler, as for example, or Hulaku? Why? Because they, subhanAllah, sometimes I believe, Allah said, but maybe some people want to join Islam. Let us poke them and get out. Get out, bark. Enjoy barking. Freedom of rights, some people are talking. When Macron himself was insulted through the news, lawyers came out. And the man, Muslim, was kicked out of the news. Because really, it's not freedom of choice, freedom of speech. It's freedom to insult. But subhanAllah, sometimes they need something. وَيَمْكُرُونَ وَيَمْكُرُ اللَّهُ وَاللَّهُ خَيْرُ الْمَكَرِينَ They want to insult the Prophet, and they don't know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about him what? وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرَكَ عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ He's above all of that. Anyone insulting him, it's not affecting him physically. Last but not least, what if you want to know one thing about the Prophet? See what was happening before the Prophet and what's happening after the Prophet. What happened before the Prophet? Information was neglectable. No one knows information, only the elite people who knows information, knows how to write and read. The elite only. And not all the elite, only the rich people. Only the rich people can do it. Subhanallah. Only the rich people can do it. But subhanallah, the Quran said came with Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. The first thing he said, what? Iqra. Read. That's why in Ghazwat Badr, the first thing that the Prophet did, imagine he had some captures of war. What he wants, like any king? Money. Give me money. What the Prophet did, alayhi salam? No. He said, if you cannot afford money, teach 10 of the Sahaba how to read and write, and you can leave. Then teaching is very important. Learning is very important. Always reflect the first ayah in the Quran, the Prophet narrated, Iqra. And the first ayah in the book of Quran, Alif Lam Mim, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابِ. This is the book. Read and the book. We are. We should know that we need to learn. That's what happened. The technology came after the Prophet. The information came after the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. This is the messenger. I wish that the freedom of speech be dealt in a good manner, that you don't insult. Learn. If you have a question, come and ask. If you're ignorant, stop talking. اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت وعافنا فيمن عافيت وتولنا فيمن توليت اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا اللهم الحقنا بنبيك كما آمنا به ولم نره اللهم الحقنا بنبيك كما آمنا به ولم نره اللهم الحقنا بنبيك كما آمنا به ولم نره اللهم ارفع مقامه يا رب العالمين فوق الأشاد اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وتوفنا صالحين اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولمن سبقنا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين وقوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم الله